A very warm welcome to one and all. I am Professor M.S. Patil, Department of Mechanical Engineering, Maratha Vidya Prasarak Samajas, Karmavira Advocate Baburao Ganpatrao Thakre College of Engineering. Today, we are going to study about the design procedure of knuckle joint, and we will solve a numerical on it. In the previous video, we have seen what is knuckle joint and what are the different modes of failures of knuckle joint. The learning objectives of today's session are, first, we will revise the generalized design procedure of knuckle joint, and then we are going to solve a numerical on knuckle joint. Starting with, this is a two-dimensional sketch of a knuckle joint. We can see there are three elements in the assembly of a knuckle joint. One is eye, second one is fork, and the third one is the knuckle. The various dimensions of the knuckle joint are as follows. D is the diameter of the rod. These are the rods which are to be connected with the help of the knuckle joint. You can see D is the diameter over here. This is D is the diameter of the rod. D is the diameter of the rod. Then D1 is the enlarged diameter of each rod. This is D1, enlarged diameter of each rod. Then small d is the diameter of knuckle pin. This is the diameter of knuckle pin, small d. D1 is the diameter of knuckle pin head. DO is the external diameter of eye and fork. X is the distance, which is approximately taken as 10 mm. A is the thickness of the fork. And B is the thickness of the eye. The knuckle joint is subjected to a tensile force P, and due to the action of this tensile force, various elements in the assembly of knuckle joint, that is eye, fork and knuckle pin, are subjected to different types of stresses. And according to the failure modes, we can derive the equation for the design of the various dimensions. Now, the design procedure can be summarized as: first, considering the tensile failure of each rod, we can calculate the diameter by using the generalized equation of stress is equal to force upon area. Rewriting the equation, we can calculate the diameter of each rod. Then we can calculate the diameter of enlarged portion of each rod, that is capital D1, as 1.1 times capital D, where D is the diameter of the rod. Then we can calculate the thickness of eye and thickness of fork. Thickness of fork can be taken as 0.75D and thickness of eye can be taken as 1.25D. Then we can calculate the diameter of the knuckle pin considering shear failure and bending failure. Considering shear failure, in double shear, we can calculate D is equal to under root 2P by pi tau. Or considering the bending failure, we can calculate the diameter using this particular equation. And from the two values which are obtained from shear criteria and bending criteria, we can select the maximum value of the knuckle pin. Then we can calculate the dimensions of DO and D1. DO is the external diameter and D1 is the diameter which can be calculated using this relations. DO is equal to twice D and D1 is equal to 1.5D. Then, after calculating all the dimensions, we can check the eye and the fork for tensile, crushing and shear stresses. The stresses can be calculated using tensile failure equation. Sigma T is equal to P divided by B DO minus T. Crushing failure, P divided by BD, tau, P divided by P DO minus T. And for the safety of the eye, the calculated stresses, tensile stress, crushing stress and shear stresses, should be less than the permissible stresses. Similar will be for the checking of tensile crushing and shear stresses for the fork. Using these equations, we can calculate sigma T, sigma C and tau for the fork. And then we can check it with the permissible stresses. If the values of the calculated stresses are within the permissible stresses, then we can say that the eye and the fork are safe against tensile crushing and shear stresses. Then we will solve a numerical. According to the statement, it is required to design a knuckle joint to connect two circular rods subjected to axial tensile force of 50 kN. This is the tensile force given. The rods are coaxial and a small amount of angular movement between their axes is permissible. If this statement is mentioned, that means we have to design a knuckle joint, because in case of knuckle joint, only a small amount of angular movement between the axes is possible. In quarter joint, it is not possible. Design the joint and specify the dimension of its components. The material for two rods and pin is plain carbon steel of grade 30C8, for which the yield stress in tension, SYT, is given as 400 Newton per mm square. It is further assumed that the yield strength in compression is equal to yield strength in tension. This may not be the case always, but in this particular numerical, it is mentioned that SYT, yield stress in strength in tension, is given equal to SYC, that is yield strength in compression. And a factor of safety of 5 is provided. Now, first we will derive what is given, what is the given data. Load is given as 50 kN. SYT, which is equal to SYC, is given as 400 Newton per mm square. And factor of safety of 5 is provided. Using this data, we can calculate the permissible stresses. According to principal stress theory, sigma t is equal to SYT upon factor of safety, sigma c SYC upon factor of safety, and according to maximum shear stress theory, tau is equal to SSY upon factor of safety. So these are the permissible values of stresses for calculating the various dimensions. Then one by one, we will calculate the dimensions. First, we will go for tensile failure of rods for calculating the diameter of rod. Using this equation, we can calculate the diameter of rod. Sigma t is provided, p is given. Putting all the values, we will get 28.21. We can round up it to 30 mm. So we have obtained the diameter of rod. Then the enlarged portion of the rod can be calculated as 1.1 times capital D. So 1.1 times 30. We got 33, round up it to 35 mm. So we got the enlarged diameter of the rod. Then we can calculate the dimensions A and B. A is the thickness of each fork and B is the thickness of the eye. Using this empirical formula, small a is equal to 0.75d and b is equal to 1.25d, we can calculate them and round up them to the nearest values, where A, thickness of each eye of fork, and B is the thickness of I end. We can calculate them. Then, after calculating A and B, we can calculate the diameter of knuckle pin based on shear criteria and based on bending criteria. Using the shear stress equation, we can calculate diameter as 28.21, which can be round up to 30 mm. And using bending stress criteria, we can calculate the diameter as 38.79, which can be round up to 40 mm. Here, according to shear, the diameter is 30 mm. According to bending, the diameter is 40 mm. Select the maximum diameter, which can be equal to 40 mm. So, diameter of knuckle pin is 40 mm. Then, we can calculate DO and D1 dimensions using empirical relation as 80 mm and 60 mm. DO is the outside diameter of eye or fork, and D1 is the diameter of knuckle pin head. So DO and D1 are obtained. Using all these dimensions, now we can calculate the permissible, we can calculate the induced stresses in the eye first. For eye, sigma t comes out to be 31.25, which is less than 80 Newton per mm square. So we can say that the eye is self in tension. And using crushing stress equation, the calculated value of crushing stress equals to 31.25 again, which is again less than 80 Newton per mm square. So we can say that the eye is safe in crushing. And then we can calculate tau, which again comes out to be 31.25 Newton per mm square, which is less than the permissible value of 40 Newton per mm square. So all the three stresses, tensile stress, crushing stress, and shear stresses, are well within the permissible limits. So eye is safe against all conditions. Similarly, we can go for checking of stresses in the fork also. Using tensile stress equation, the value comes out to be 25. Using crushing stress equation, the value comes out to be 25 again. And for tau, the value is again 25 newton per mm square, which are less than 80 newton per mm square against tension, 80 newton per mm square against crushing, and 40 newton per mm square again tau. So we can say that the stresses are well within the limits, and therefore the fork is safe against tension, compression, and shear. So from this step, it is clear that the stresses are within the limit and we are safe. So this is the numerical for the knuckle joint. Thank you for listening it very patiently. In the next lecture, we will talk about the different types of levers. What are the different types of levers and how to design the cross section of levers, how to design the fulcrum pins, and how to calculate the stresses. You can see it in the next video. Thank you. Thank you very much.